G'day folks, this is Sim and welcome back to 7 Days to Die. So we're going to start work on our mining operation, which is long overdue. I was originally planning to put it out on this little peninsula here, but I've decided that I'm going to spice things up just a little bit, nothing really exciting, by putting the pier out and actually dropping it down into the middle of the lake. Now that means that I am going to have to fill in an area and clear, so let's head down. It's reasonably deep here but not too bad, and what we're going to be doing is we're going to be putting rebar frames down, and then we're going to be filling in the center with dirt to clear the area out. So let's get the basic place in place here. Hopefully I've got enough rebar frames. If not, I'll have to make some more up. What was that gap again? That's 5 internally. That's correct. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yep, so 5 should be more than enough inside. And we'll come this way a little more. Probably not going to have enough frames, to be honest. I'm probably going to have to make some more up. We'll see how we go. That's 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, yep, I think I went a little bit too far here. Okay, this should get ourselves up and out of the water. Oh, plain day. Do we want to make a run? Do I have the space? Yes, I do. Tell you what, I'll cut out and I'll come back when we get there, okay? Okay, so it came down in the wasteland and I couldn't get a clean line on it, so I'm not sure exactly where it's dropped. I know it's around here somewhere. Ow, that hurt. Oh, that really hurt. Is that it there? Looks like it is. Oh, okay. Med supplies, iron leg armor. That's one of the ones that we needed, I'm pretty sure. Let's have a quick look. Yep, we've got scrap, so the only other piece that we really need is the helmet, and that's not critical anyway. Alright, so that was the score. Now, where are we in relation to... Okay, we're back here. And... Alright. Okay, so... Our little base is just around here. We've got a pack making their way over to us. It's pretty quiet at the moment. There are a few around, but I don't have massive issues with dogs. I am very tempted to make a run down the main street and see if we can find anything worthwhile. So, let's do it. We're in town. We don't have the massive spawn numbers that we were having before. So, let's see what we can do. Now we are going to have to be careful. That looks interesting. What do we have here? Oh, that's a shotgun messiah. Okay, that's one of the buildings that I've been looking for. Because the shotgun messiahs have a whole bunch of weaponry in them, and I might be able to find the last piece I need for the magnum in there. How are we going to get inside? Let's just take out this one. Ooh. Oh, that was a bit mean. We don't have a lot of space. Just want to switch over to a bandage to stop that bleeding. Is there a back door is the first question. There is. I think that's how we're going to have to get in here. There is a ladder up onto the roof, but I doubt we'll be able to get in through the roof. So, while it's quiet, Hopefully we won't attack. Oh, okay, that's the that is the garage that I was in one of my earlier runs. I was that close to this building. Okay. Let's do this. It's going to make a little bit of a racket. Fortunately, we do have some rebar frames to block ourselves in with afterwards. We're rapidly running out of time, so we may have to... Come on. I don't want to switch to the axe. I don't have time. Come on. Okay, now we've got somebody around the front. So before we duck in here, I want to see if I can take care of the company at the front so we don't have to worry about them trying to break in. Because, yeah, that cop is doing a lot of damage. And that was a complete miss. Run! Ouch. That hurt a lot. How much damage did he do to the place? I'm rapidly running out of time here. Okay, not too bad. That door's not taken out completely. And how about we just throw some cinder block in front of it. Can I get one on top there? Probably not. Nah, okay, but either way, that should slow them down a little bit. Let's get in the back door and let's hope we don't have too much in the way of company. Did I check that card? No, can't help myself. It's, oh, don't need that. So much quieter at the moment. It's scary compared to what I've dealt with before. Not sure why it's so quiet, but I'm not going to complain. So let's seal that one up and let's get some light in this place. And we're going to have the same issues that we had with the hardware store. We're going to have to break our way into these crates. And I'm going to have to break my way through another wall. Alright. Okay, this is going to take a little bit of work. I don't have a lot of space, unfortunately. We've got plenty of first aid kits, so I'm going to heal up. Try and stay quiet. But first I need to break the door and get the inside area lit up. So let's see if we can get away with this. And I will cut back in once I've worked my way through this door. Okay, so the night was pretty uneventful and I've taken the time to open up all the crates or take the outer casing off anyway. So let's have a look and see whether we're going to get lucky or not. Okay, well, we're off to a good start. Sniper scope, not too shabby. Don't really need short stock. Unfortunately, we do have the sniper rifle, even though we're not carrying it around with us at the moment. Let's see how we go in here. Pump shotgun stock. Another pump shotgun stock. Two left. Sniper handguard. Again, nice, but not what we really were after. And last but not least, a pistol slide. Okay, so that's depressing, but we do know how to get back here later now, so that's not too bad. What? Oh, okay, that looked like a full shotgun there for a second. Hang on a sec. Alright, let's just break this stuff down while we're here. Not that one. Alright. Could have been prettier, but it wasn't. There was nothing in the safe that was worth getting excited about, and I don't really need the lead trophy. So look, let's make a run for home, and let's take this fella out. Look at them, they're coming straight away. Oh dear. Let's just run. And hope we're going in the right direction. Yeah, we are. Right. Ooh. Tempted to jump up there simply because we get up. There's often a safe up here, but in this case there isn't. A couple of glass jars and a not so white tank top. Alright, so I can't help myself. Let's have a quick look and see what this building over here is before we leave. Oh, hello. Anything nasty close by? Nope. What do we got here? Ah, okay, that's a police station. I am kind of tempted to break into there. So much for go away. I heard you for a change, and another one. Oh, did you not see me? Oh, yes, you did. We're going to have too many here to deal with. Bleeding? How many hits do you want? Oh, and infected as well. That's just a little rude. Okay, I think I'm going to have to come back here. Oops, particularly when I do stupid things like this. Didn't take much damage in all of that, but yeah, I've attracted too much attention over here. I'll come back when I'm ready to make a proper raid on the city like I intended. Hey doggy. I'm gonna have stamina problems now, aren't I? Let's get rid of you. And let's get some beer into us. Oh, we've got antibiotics, we may as well take them. Another dog, oops. And some beer. Oh, I can't drink at the moment, I'm full. That's okay. Alright, so it won't take long to get home, and I'll meet you back there and we will finish what we started. Okay, so the framework's in place. It's flickering pretty badly, as you can see. So I'm not going to subject you to too much of this. I need to get the cement in, and to do that I also need to seriously empty out the water out of the centre. So we'll get that done next. Okay, so that's filled with dirt. The next step is to empty that back out again. Okay, so now we can get the concrete in place, but before we do that, we're just gonna get down around the outer edge and we are going to put some spikes down just to give us that little bit of extra protection because they will still come at us through the water. As you can see over there, you can probably see that pack right there. Get up, breathe before it's too late. And I'm going to have to get these spikes fully upgraded. Yep, and that pack is coming straight at us. Let's see whether or not we can at least. Oops, I'm going to drown. Get this front one upgraded one level. Oh, I didn't realize that you could upgrade those. Almost on top of us now. Get that spike down quickly. Oop. Right. Now, I had no idea you could actually upgrade these logs. However, I have to be honest, I think that they look better as logs as opposed to the wooden, so we're going to leave them like that. So we got that pack there, and what I might do, I think, is draw them away. They're probably going to go around, but I don't want them breaking what I'm working on right now. It's not a very large pack, so I'll draw them away and I'll come back and do the concreting. Right, so the mining shack is finished, but I did think there might be a good idea to show off something that I had been working on while I was healing because I don't think I've actually showed this off properly. I've put some towers on either ends of the front wall. Now, it shows quite clearly the ridiculousness of putting this line of trees here because it does block a massive amount of view, but I don't care, they look good, and right now that's probably more important to me. So let's just head down. So I will be putting escape tunnels into here that will connect up with the inside of the base and possibly with the mining or maybe somewhere further away so that I've got somewhere where I can do a runner if I need to, if things get bad. I have had one solid invasion that's come in, and the defenses did a pretty good job, but I have learned that essentially I probably should have gone with the concrete down below initially, because that's where all of the focus is. They fall down when they're trying to get at me, and then they churn through. And you can see a couple of places here where I've had to do concrete repairs. Now, I do need this mining operation pretty desperately because I am now completely out of steel or iron, and that means that I'm going to have to go mining. Now, I could go back to my cliff face, but the whole point in doing this was to give us a mining operation. So let's have a look at the finished product. Okay, so I've capped the top layer off with wood and then put a roof on here, added some spikes just in case they do somehow manage to get up onto here. I can't unfortunately put a door in because you can't place a door on top of a stair, which is a little bit frustrating. It would be nice to be able to put a door in here. However, I can seal it up without too much grief, just using the frames. Now it comes down and then it does a switchback, and the reason I've done that is because if they do manage to get down into here and they're trying to get at me, then chances are they're not smart enough to go around here and back down here. They're probably just going to stand here and beat on this wall. In most cases, they're not likely to get in anyway, but that's just an added bit of security. Now, I could have dug a vertical shaft straight down. That's perfectly reasonable, but I've gone with a 45 degree shaft that I can just walk down. And I've come down a fairly decent way, and you can see that I've started work on side tunnels here. So I've opened up a little 5x5 area. I've put some chests down to store excess materials as they come up, and I'm going to be putting some forges down here as well, which will attract attention. But they will attract attention to the middle of the lake, which is that was the main intent. The reason that we're doing it this way is that we want spider zombies who are investigating forges to basically be floating around up top. Now, they're probably going to try and dig down, but they are in fact quite a long way up, so it's going to take a little bit of work. And I'm seriously thinking about putting some spikes above as well, so if they do tend to focus over this area, they're probably going to die on the spikes. Unfortunately, the whole trip down here and the initial tunnels that I've dug have all resulted in absolutely no ore at all. But that's just luck. I'll strike some soon enough. I tend to do my manual digging with the pickaxe. You can use the auger, the auger does some odd things. It rides up when you're using it, which can make it very hard at times to get these tunnels nice and clean. And as long as the pickaxe is well repaired, it doesn't take long to dig. It's about 4 hits or 5 hits with a fresh pick to take out a block, which isn't too shabby. And what I will do is, once I strike ore, then I'll go get the auger and I will use that to excavate a larger area underground. Okay, so in the meantime, we'll head back upstairs. Because I think we're probably going to call this episode here. I'm just going to be doing some mining for a while and rebuild my iron supplies, hopefully. So it's probably going to be a few days game time again before I come back. When I come back, we're going to be hitting the road and we're going to continue our journey to find the new biomes and the last piece of the magnum that we need to make that up. So, I hope you enjoyed this episode. Look forward to seeing you next time. Until then, take care of each other, everyone, and ciao for now.